Today we're going to be talking about the construction plane, or as Rhino likes to refer to it interchangeably as, the seaplane.
The seaplane is like a tabletop that helps you keep track of your changes. The construction plane grid lies on the seaplane. The dark red line represents the x-axis. The green line represents the y-axis. And the red and the green lines meeting at the center here indicates the origin. And because we're working in three-dimensional space, the z-axis would be straight up from the plane origin. It's kind of like a digital workbench, and it helps you model things accurately because your first click, set to a coordinate, will always be on the seaplane.
So for example, if we draw a box, the box will sit perfectly on the construction plane. We can change the properties of the grid, including the line counts and the units of measurements used, by heading up to the top menu, clicking on File, then Settings, and then we can find our options under Grid and the Units tabs. Now with the shape that we've created on our seaplane, we're going to add a new custom seaplane right on top of this shape so that we can easily add to our design by putting another shape above it. Heading up to the top of our screen, we're going to click on the View drop-down menu and then head up to the Seaplane menu. Here we can see the different ways we can define our new seaplane that we're creating. We're going to keep it simple. We're going to click on the two object option and define our new seaplane. To do this, we're simply going to click the surface of our box that we want to place our seaplane on, and Rhino will automatically place it in the center of that surface. Now we're using this new seaplane, you can see, as a draw a new shape. It's placed directly on top of our original box. It's also possible to save seaplanes to work with. This helps because you can quickly switch between them and create complex geometries faster. To do that, we're going to head back up again to the View drop-down menu at the top of the screen, and then we're going to go to the Set Seaplane menu again, and right down the bottom here, we're going to click on the Show Named Seaplanes panel. This is where we can quickly create and save seaplanes, and also quickly switch between them while we're working. We're going to add a seaplane, then we're going to use the button here on the left in the Tools panel, next to the little red car. I'm going to click that and hold it to see our different options of how to define our seaplane. Exactly the same process that we did before, except now we have the option of adding seaplanes continuously and saving them by clicking on the plus button. Now that we've defined and saved these seaplanes, we can quickly switch between them by double-clicking them or highlighting them and clicking the Restore button in the bottom right-hand corner of the named Construction Planes panel. To use the construction plane for accurate modeling, simply ensure that the Grid Snap Modeling Guide option is toggled on here at the top of the screen. If for some reason you can't see that, just head over to Rhino Preferences Modeling Aids and you can see all your options here. That's it for our introduction to seaplanes. I hope that helps you design more complex geometry faster in Rhino. If you would like any other resources, including help with 3D printing, 3D data, and design, please have a look at the description below for our Git book.